Hello, and welcome to your pretty much annual lookbook where I failed to post for the past year due to this hot mess of a quarantine. I feel like I've developed a bit of a style over the past quarantine, and you know, I decided to show it in a video, so thank me later, I guess. I don't know, man.
With
something a bit more casual, here I have an outfit that is super easy to throw on and something I would definitely see myself wearing on a lazier day and still feel like the body that I am, which I'm definitely improving day by day, as you can see right on your screen. I'm wearing a simple ripped tank top, which I made myself. However, if school's taught me anything, shoulders are just not accepted, so to kind of cover it up, I learned a denim jacket, even though we all know that's not staying where the shoulders are. To really embody that whole high ponytail phase I had back in 7th grade, I tied my hair up to show those boys that, no, my shoulders shouldn't be distracting from your work, you're just kinda weird, man. And the fact that I thought it suited this outfit well, and I also ended up tying a shoelace from one of my other shoes, which ended up being pretty disgusting. I'm almost certain that there's at least one, if not two, COVID strains of them at this point, to my jeans since they were a bit loose. And to really immerse myself into the whole school-esque type beat, I got in my backpack that tied well with the stitching on the boots, which I think is pretty cute. And is it just me, or can we bring back the whole summer visco phase? I mean, if you think about it, they didn't really do anything wrong, even though I may be a little bit biased considering I went through the phase myself. But if you think about it, they were saving turtles. They were, you know, the worst thing they could have done was hit you in the face with a hydro flask, or worse, this was a lot of fun, you're my head, or when I wrote this 3 days ago. So I'm the person to come to school in an extra outfit, but if I ever woke up on the right side of the bed and felt like a bad beep, I'm Addison Ray. You bet, I will be putting together an outfit that radiates that vibe. And by the way, apparently she came out with a new song, so I guess I can say I'm obsessed with this outfit. But for real though, this is probably the closest I get to my very limited wardrobe, something business casual, as I think the plaid pants really does it for me, as well as the satin tank top that— what is this blobfish looking at? Now that I think about it, it's probably a very bad idea that I'm putting out the footage to the public, because it's self-explanatory. We got that rich bag that makes it seem like my parents bribed their way to college for me, if not already, but it kind of ties the whole look together. And of course, we can't forget about the one thing I depend on to look like a solid 5'4", with the hefty price of around 44 Big Macs. You could probably do the math at this point, but Doc Martens, man. As someone who dances quite a bit, and as a result binge watches an absurd amount of 1 million Studios dance videos, I've been a bit obsessed with wearing just oversized clothes that in a way takes away the hourglass silhouette society deems as the only acceptable one, but it gives that kind of, I don't know, swag vibe type beat, if you know what I'm saying. And I think the bucket hat really does that whole mysterious or kind of cool vibe, because you can't see my eyes, and nor can I, as it basically covers half of my face. Or the fact that you're just watching a video behind the screen, in which I wouldn't be able to anyways. Kinda sad, man. Overall, we just have a pretty neutral theme going on here, with blacks and off-whites and such stuff, and now I look like I'm about to dance like my rent is due, when the only move I know is the whoa. Whoa. Oh, whoa. As I'm guessing a lot of you guys have as well, I've kind of immersed myself into the whole TikTok lifestyle. Everything I have to eat has to be approved by the H&L, even though she doesn't have to tell me it's bussin', and I haven't been able to pronounce Da Vinci correctly, which leads to this outfit. What a long transition, but we got there. Growing up, I was a bit of that stereotypical art kid, quiet, sitting in the back of the room, and for my instance, just really weird, as I still am, except I'm somewhat more interactive, I guess, and I can somewhat talk to people now. So hey kids, honestly this outfit is a bit stereotypical with the beret. I just kind of sewed together with the craft felt from Joann's and the whole layering with the turtleneck. I also have this funky bag that I thought really adds that pop of color, so I'd say this is probably one of my more creative outfits in this lookbook. So if I could say one thing about this outfit, it's that your girl doesn't skate for shit. Maybe it's because it costs $95 at the lowest, and you know, not everyone has the money for that, and that person's me. So just to redeem myself, I'm really putting that whole skater vibe out there. You got the checkerboard patterns on the sleeves, the layering that's already stuck on there anyways, the gigantic logo that just screams skateboard-esque, white boy closet type V kind of thing. The skater skirt that really does that statement justice, you know, it's just all laid out in front of you. I also thought these space ones were really kind of cute. They're really enhancing that skater vibe that I kind of imagine, and is your outfit really an outfit without some matching clips? That's right, no ma'am, no sir. My previous outfits are absolutely quivering in fear. By the way, I also happen to have the exact same skirt as Best Dress, which if you think about it that much, but not a lot, it's just a lot more than I could ever ask for. So you know it's getting to spring when you start bringing the shortalls out. The flowers are blooming, including those nasty egg ones, and why do shortalls sound so weird? Are they even called that? We'll never know. For this outfit, we got a whole picnic vibe going on here, especially with the basket, which is a bit dysfunctional on a day-to-day basis, but really speaks for the whole picnic thing itself, and because quarantine really sucks that ability to interact for me, here I'm just dressing up and pretending like I'm having a picnic in my room by myself. So that's kind of sad to watch, not gonna lie. I also really like how the jacket pretty much cuts right at the ends of the overalls for that kind of tight-knit, easy boxy silhouette. You know, it's cute, bro. I would probably wear it when I go to the supermarket or just anywhere. It's cute, yo.